Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting facts including SIDBI's measures for helping MSMEs. So let's begin today's video, but before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel till now, then guys do subscribe and hit the bell notification, and you can join this Telegram group of ours where we provide you with free quizzes as well as latest updates about the examination. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, then you can join this channel through the link given in the description below. Guys, this is the RBI Grade B 2022 course for you, where you will get PDFs, videos and mocks along with interview preparation. So we conduct mock interviews so that your final interviews can be prepared. And this is the booklet that you will get at your place if you enroll in this new course. And that booklet contains all the books mentioned right in front of you. And right now we are running a 30% discount on the course. So if you are willing to avail that discount, you can use RBI 30 coupon code. And if you have any query while enrolling into the course or related to the examination, then you can just call us on the number right in front of you. So that was all for the introduction part. Now let's begin with the first question, that is telling us about the measures of SIDBI that SIDBI has taken in order to help MSMEs. So the first question is, how much amount is the corpus of SIDBI's Prayas scheme? 2000 1000 1500 2000 3000, so it's not 2000 again here, it's the 4000 amount. Okay, so what is the right answer here? So the right answer here is option B, that is 1000. So 1000 is the corpus of this Prayas scheme. Guys, Prayas is just one scheme under the different measures taken by SIDBI. So let us understand the different measures of SIDBI one by one, including this Prayas scheme. So the first initiative that SIDBI has taken for MSMEs is that SIDBI has reduced the interest rates on credit availed by the MSMEs under the TWARIT scheme. So this TWARIT stands for Timely Working Capital Assistance to Revitalize Industries in the Times of Corona Crisis. So this is the full form of TWARIT. And from the full form itself, it is very evident that the purpose of launching this scheme was to help the MSMEs in their working capital requirements by providing them credit. Now, since it is mentioning Corona itself, therefore it is very obvious to remember the year of its launch. So it was launched in 2020 under the Emergency Credit Line Guarantee scheme. Now this scheme was launched as part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package, wherein the loans of the people were guaranteed by the government. So that was launched in order to promote or boost the economy. And under that ECLGS scheme only, this TWARIT scheme was launched by SIDBI. Now under this scheme, at the time of its launch, 8.25% interest was charged, but right now this interest rate has been reduced to 6%, and this is precisely the current change that has taken place in this scheme. The next point here that we need to understand is that the loan amount under this scheme is 25 crore at the maximum, and it is provided at an interest rate of 6%, as we have already discussed, for the period of 4 years plus 1 year of moratorium. Okay, the next point here is that the loans under this scheme would be sanctioned till September 2021 and disbursements will take place till December 2021 or until the notification comes out from the National Credit Guarantee Trustee Company. So whichever is earlier, till that time disbursement of the loans will be done under this scheme. So that was all about this first scheme. Now guys, this point is not very important for you to remember, the last one, the time period for which the disbursement and sanctions will take place, because that is something that is dynamic. It can change from time to time. If SIDBI extends this period, so it will change definitely. So this is not very important for you to remember. The most important part of this entire initiative is that the interest rate, because that is the new change that has taken place, and the loan amount, that is 25 crores. So that was the first initiative. Now let's move on to the second initiative, that is the Prayas scheme. Now guys, you would be thinking, like, TWARIT, does this Prayas also have a full form? So guys, Prayas does not have a full form, because Prayas stands for the Hindi word Prayas, that means effort. So Prayas is the name of this scheme, which gives loans of up to 5 lakh at 13% interest to the MSMEs. Okay, and the total corpus of this scheme is rupees 1000 crores. Under this scheme, now the current change is that under this scheme, SIDBI has announced to launch the Swavalamban Challenge Fund and the Swavalamban Facilitation Center. Now, what is the purpose of launching both these things, the fund as well as the center? The purpose is to provide the mentoring and credit to the micro entrepreneurs in villages and small towns through microfinance institutions. Obviously, in villages and small towns, microfinance institutions are the one institutions that have its reach, so that have extended reach in the villages and rural areas. Therefore, through those institutions, SIDBI is planning to give out loans to small entrepreneurs in those regions through the Swavalamban Challenge Fund as well as Swavalamban Facilitation Center. So the fund would be providing the financial support, as well as the center would be providing the guidance and mentorship support to these entrepreneurs under this scheme. The next point here is that a Swavalamban chair for MSME solutions was also launched by SIDBI at the Government Engineering College in Thrissur, Kerala, to promote entrepreneurship among students. So basically, a Swavalamban chair, that is a chair, a different field of study, or basically a chair is something that you can say as a academic space that has been given to a particular purpose or to a particular subject. For example, here this chair is going to be established for promoting the MSMEs or promoting the entrepreneurship among these students, so that they can take up the entrepreneurship. They can also start their own business at the micro, small and medium level. So that is the purpose of establishing this Swavalamban chair. And for that, the SIDBI has signed the MOU with this college in Kerala. So that was the second initiative. Now let's discuss the third initiative, wherein SIDBI has partnered or collaborated with CIM SME, which is the MSME body in India. So CIM SME stands for Confederation of Indian Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. And SIDBI and this CIM SME have collaborated in order to set up the Swavalamban Suvidha Kendra. So under this Swavalamban Suvidha Kendra, basically authentic information about the different kinds of schemes and different kinds of technologies and government portals will be provided to the MSMEs. So basically there is information disbalance among the MSMEs. They don't have proper information about the registration, about the schemes that are going to benefit them only. So in order to curb that hurdle, in order to overcome that hurdle, this Swavalamban Suvidha Kendra will be established by SIDBI and CIM SME, under which the information related to the government schemes, to the facets that are affecting the lives of MSMEs, will be provided. So there are certain portals like Udyam registration portal that allows the MSMEs to register themselves, and thereby they can avail the benefits of the government schemes. And we also have Udyam Mitra portal, Stand Up Mitra portal, PSB loans in 59 minutes, etc. So these are different government portals, and information regarding all these portals will be provided through this Swavalamban Suvidha Kendra that will be established by SIDBI and CIM SME. So I hope that this third initiative is also clear to you. Now let's discuss the last initiative, that is project management units that will be set up by SIDBI on the recommendation of UK Sinha Committee on MSMEs. So this UK Sinha Committee submitted its recommendations on MSMEs in the year 2019. Your task is to tell me that when was this committee formed. So moving on further to this fourth initiative. So under this project management units, basically the purpose of this project management unit would be to identify the employment or entrepreneurship opportunities among the migrant population. So we have already seen how the migrant population is coming back to their different states, as well as the immigrants are also coming back to their own country, basically in India. So how to use their potential, how to convert their potential into the industrial benefit towards the entrepreneurship benefit. So that is the purpose of this project management unit. So how is it going to be done? So this project management units basically will profile the migrants, their skills, their skill set and their education background from the 11 states. And thereby, when the inputs will be there, then the plan of action will be prepared by these project management units. So basically, the basic purpose of setting up project management units would be to encourage the entrepreneurship among the migrants. So that is the one-line purpose of SIDBI's measures for MSMEs. So I hope that this news is clear to you. I am moving on to the next question now. Which country is developing world's first tunnel for cruise ships? Norway, Denmark, Finland, Sweden and Bulgaria. Out of these, Norway is the right answer. Now guys, this tunnel will be prepared through the mountains. So basically, there is a stretch of mountain from one point to the next point. There is mountain, and that mountain will be broken down in order to prepare that tunnel for cruise ships. Now, on which sea is this world's first tunnel for cruise ships is going to be developed? So, the name of that sea is Skagvest Sea. So, this is the name of the sea, Skagvest Sea, on which this world's first tunnel for cruise ship will be built by Norway. So, that was all about this question. Now, we are moving on to the third question. Who among the following has been appointed as the governor of Goa? So, you have the five options: P.S. Sridharan Pillai, Satyadev Narayan Arya, Ramesh Bais, Hari Babu Kambhapti, Rajendra Vishwanath Arlekar. So, out of these options, the right answer is option A. P.S. Sridharan Pillai is the new governor of Goa. So, recently, President of India, that is Ram Nath Kovind, has appointed the new governors for 8 states. So, this is the list of the names of governors as well as their states. Now, here, the most notable name is the Thavarchand Gehlot's name, because he is at present the Union Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment. And because he has been appointed as the governor of Karnataka, therefore, he has to resign from his position, because a governor cannot be a member of the parliament, or he cannot be a minister at the same time if he is acting as the governor. So, he has been appointed as the governor. Therefore, he has announced that he is going to resign from the Rajya Sabha membership post as well as from the ministry. Now, he has also made the announcement that he is going to resign from this position as well as the governor of Karnataka. But let's see how the things turn out, whether he resigns from being the governor of Karnataka or not. But at present, you have to remember that the governor cannot be the union minister as well as he cannot hold the position in the legislature of either the state or the country. Okay. And the rest are the names of different states for where the governors have been appointed. So, you have to memorize the names of all these people, because governors are important, and in the past you have been asked questions on governors in your examination. So, be it RBI, be it SEBI, or be it any examination at the level of banking PO, the governors have always been important for your examination. So, do not ignore them, just memorize the governors of these states. Yes, you don't have to remember the governors of previous states or these people's previous territory, previous state as their governors. You can remember the names of these people and the current state where they have been appointed as the governor. Okay, so I hope that this is clear to you. Now, let's move on to the next question, which is a very interesting question. So, who among the following is India's first transgender police officer? Amarpal Pritika Yashini, Rajkumar Singh Thakur, Santosh Kumar, Vibhuti Bhushan Das. Out of these options, the right answer is option B, Pritika Yashini. So, she has become India's first transgender police officer. There is nothing much to it, but since it is the first time that a transgender person has got acceptance in the police department, or it's the first time nationwide that a transgender person has become the police officer, therefore, it is important that you should know the name of that person at least. So, it is Pritika Yashini. So, remember the name of that person. Okay. So, next question is, who has won the Kuvempu Rashtriya Puraskar for 2020? Pavan Reddy, Rajendra Kishore Panda, Aranya Johar, Harneet Kumar, Alok Ved Menon are the options, out of which option B, that is Rajendra Kishore Panda is the right answer. Now, guys, this award has been instituted by Rashtriya Kuvempu Trust. So, this trust has established this award in 2013 in order to honor the people who have done a great job in the literatures of the official languages of India. So, why did I use the word official? Because the languages that have been approved by the Constitution of India and the people who have done great job towards the literature or the language, they are awarded this award. So, Kuvempu Rashtriya Award is given to Rajendra Kishore Panda, who is the Odia poet. So, remember that he is the Odia poet. This is another fact that can be asked from you guys. Okay. Next is, who among the following will be India's flag bearer at the opening ceremony of the Tokyo Olympics? MC Mary Kom, Manpreet Singh, Bajrang Punia, both A and B, and both B and C. So, the right answer here is option D, both A and B. MC Mary Kom and Manpreet Singh are going to be the Indian flag bearers at the opening ceremony of Tokyo Olympics, whereas Bajrang Punia would be the flag bearer at the closing ceremony on 8th August. Now, guys, first of all, the very first thing that you should know here is that MC Mary Kom is the boxer, Manpreet Singh is the captain of Indian men's hockey team, whereas Bajrang Punia is a wrestler. The next thing here is that this is the first time that a female has been appointed, or we can say a female is going to be the flag bearer of India at the Tokyo Olympics. So this time a male as well as a female are going to be the flag bearer. So this is the first time. Okay, so that was all about this question. I hope there is nothing much from the video itself that you cannot understand or memorize. So if there is any problem in understanding anything, you can ask me in the comment section below. On that note, let's finish this video today. Thank you so much for watching the video.